Equities continued to rally in the fourth quarter as a sharp bounce in the global economy from historic monetary but especially fiscal stimulus overwhelmed investor worry over mounting COVID infections. Global equities rose almost 9%, with Canadian and international stocks outperforming their U.S. counterparts. Emerging markets were best overall, up 14% on the back of a weaker U.S. dollar. Fixed income, as defined by the FTSE Universe Index, eked out a positive return of 0.6% as gains in corporate bonds offset modest losses in government-related securities as yields rose during the quarter. Gold struggled, but other commodities performed very well, with the Bloomberg Commodity Index up over 10% in Canadian dollar terms. The Mosaic Balanced ETF portfolio rose 5.6% in the last quarter of the year, extending its calendar year 2020 return to 8.4%, a strong result in a very trying year. In terms of positioning, we maintain an overweight exposure to equities, commodities, and corporate credit while underweighting government rates. Equity valuations have expanded rapidly since the low in late March, which we expect as company earnings continue to recover into their higher multiples as the economy reboots from the COVID-related shutdowns. We believe that the combination of government spending, mass immunizations, and a unique monetary policy playbook has the potential to move growth and inflation higher into the middle of the year after one last challenge from the virus, which will weigh on growth in the first quarter. Regionally speaking, we prefer non-US equity markets, which offer more compelling valuations and earnings growth in 2021. Secular growth stocks and technology specifically dominate the US market. And while we expect to see solid earnings growth this year from the US, its low weighting in cyclical sectors is a disadvantage relative to other markets with more non-tech cyclical exposure like financials, energy, industrials, and materials. Markets like Japan, Europe, and emerging markets offer more gearing to these faster growing sectors as the global economy recovers from the COVID pandemic of the past year. Finally, we maintain our gold bullion and gold equity exposure in addition to hedged U.S. inflation protected securities to guard against a potential overshoot in inflation as it normalizes.